Hey everyone, welcome to St. Mark's Virtual. Thanks for joining us on the live stream. We're going to give everyone a few moments here to gather online before we get started. We have a full house here with all 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 people joining us in person. But again, we're grateful that everyone's taking the time and precaution to be safe and to continue to participate with us as a faith community. So again, thank you for joining us on the live stream. I'm gonna check with Nora here, who's gonna help us out and see if we've got people joining us online. Yeah, thanks for also being patient with us as we practice for the first time these sort of virtual elements. Hopefully as these sessions continue, they'll get better over time. And eventually we all look forward to being able to come back together as a congregation in person. We look forward to those moments. But for now, virtual is the way we will be. Okay, great. Any status update, Nora? Yeah, we're good. How many people do we have online so far?
13.
Great. Well, thanks everyone. I'm gonna hand things over to Jana.
Thank you for your patience, everyone. Yeah.
Hey, could everyone on the live feed feeding us comments? If you see the video, could you confirm that it's rolling? Okay. It sounds like we're all good. We're hearing a couple of technical difficulties, and we just want to check in and make sure everyone's okay. All right.
Rend your hearts and not your garments. Return to the Lord your God, for he is gracious and merciful, slow to anger, and abounding in steadfast love, and repents of evil. Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Let us pray. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us all our sins through the grace of Jesus Christ. Strengthen us in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep us in eternal life. Please stand as you are able. Lord, open our lips.
And our mouths shall proclaim your praise. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
The Lord is full of compassion and mercy. Come, let us adore him. We will say Psalm 100, the two Latin together. Be joyful in the Lord, all you hands. Serve the Lord with gladness, and come before his presence with a song. Know this, the Lord himself is God. He himself has made us, and we are his. We are his people, and the sheep of his pasture.
Enter his gates with thanksgiving. Go into his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and call
upon his name. For the Lord is good, his mercy is everlasting, and his faithfulness endures from age to age. Please be seated. We will read Psalm 95 together. Come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving and raise a loud shout to him with songs. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hand are the caverns of the earth,
and the heights of the hills are his also. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands have molded the dry land.
Come, let us bow down and bend our knee, and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is our God, sheep of his hand. Oh, today you would hearken to his voice. Harden not your hearts, as your forebears did in the wilderness, at Meribah, and on the day of Massah, when they tempted me. They put me to the test, though they had seen my works. 40 years long I detested that generation, he says. This people are wayward in their hearts. They do not know my ways. So I swore in my wrath, they shall not enter into my rest.
On page 4 in your bulletin, we will chant the Song of Simeon.
Not only that, but we also boast in our sufferings, knowing that suffering produces endurance, and endurance produces character, and character produces hope. And hope does not disappoint us, because God's love has poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. For while we were still weak, at the right time, Christ died for the ungodly. Indeed, rarely will anyone die for a righteous person, though perhaps for a good person, someone might actually dare to die. But God proves his love for us, and that while we were still were sinners, Christ died for us. Much more surely then, now that we have been justified by his blood, will we be saved through him from the wrath of God. For if, while we were enemies, we were reconciled to God through the death of his Son, much more surely, having been reconciled, will we be saved by his life. But more than that, we even boast in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have now received reconciliation. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
We will now sing the Tese chant, Bless the Lord My Soul, found on page 5 in your bulletin. Please be seated.
A reading from the Gospel according to John. Jesus came to a Samaritan city called Sychar, near the plot of ground that Jacob had given to his son Joseph. Jacob's well was there, and Jesus, tired out by his journey, was sitting by the well. It was about noon. A Samaritan woman came to draw water, and Jesus said to her, Give me a drink. His disciples had gone to the city to buy food. The Samaritan woman said to him, How is it that you, a Jew, ask a drink of me, a woman of Samaria? Jews do not share things in common with Samaritans. Jesus answered her, If you knew the gift of God And who it is that is saying to you, give me a drink, you would have asked him, and he would have given you living water. The woman said to him, sir, you have no bucket, and the well is deep. Where do you get that living water? Are you greater than our ancestor Jacob, who gave us the well, and with his sons and his flocks drank from it? Jesus said to her, everyone who drinks of this water will be thirsty again, but those who drink of the water that I will give them will never be thirsty. The water that I will give will become in them a spring of water gushing up to eternal life. The woman said to him, sir, give me this water so that I may never be thirsty and have to keep coming back here to draw water. Jesus said to her, go, call your husband and come back. The woman answered him, I have no husband. Jesus said to her, you're right in saying I have no husband, for you have had five husbands, and the one you have now is not your husband. What you have said is true. The woman said to him, sir, I see that you are a prophet. Our ancestors worshipped on this mountain, but you say that the place where people must worship is in Jerusalem. Jesus said to her, woman, believe me, the hour is coming when you will worship the Father neither on this mountain nor in Jerusalem. You worship what you do not know. We worship what we know, for salvation is from the Jews. But the hour is coming and is now here, when the true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and truth, for the Father seeks such as these to worship him. God is spirit, and those who worship him must worship in spirit and truth. The woman said to him, I know the Messiah is coming, who is called Christ. When he comes, he will proclaim all things to us. Jesus said to her, I am he, the one who is speaking to you. Just then his disciples came. They were astonished that he was speaking with a woman, but no one said, what do you want, or why are you speaking with her? Then the woman left her water jar and went back to the city. She said to the people, come and see a man who told me everything I've ever done. He cannot be the Messiah, can he? They left the city and were on their way to him. Meanwhile, the disciples were urging him, Rabbi, eat something. But he said to them, I have food to eat that you do not know about. So the disciples said to one another, surely no one has brought something to eat. Jesus said to them, my food is to do the will of him who sent me and to complete his work. Do you not say, 4 months more, then comes the harvest? I'm telling you, look around you and see how the fields are ripe for harvesting. The reaper is already receiving wages and is gathering fruit for eternal life, so that the sower and reaper may rejoice together. For here the saying holds true, one sows and another reaps. I sent you to reap that for which you did not labor. Others have labored, and you have entered into their labor. Many Samaritans from that city believed in him because of the woman's testimony. He told me everything I've ever done. So when the Samaritans came to him, they asked him to stay with them, and he stayed there 2 days. And many more believed because of his word. They said to the woman, it's no longer because of what you said that we believe, for we have heard for ourselves, and we know that this is truly the Savior of the world. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Lord, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, and courage to change the things I can, and wisdom to know the difference. Amen. Reverend Keith has said these words countless times before beginning a sermon, but I believe that today it is especially important for us to lean into that mantra. In a time when so many things fall into that first category, the things we cannot change, it can be difficult to find God's peace. For those of you who do not know me, my name is Julia Warren, and I am your junior warden. I have been working closely with Senior Warden Kay Alexander and Reverend South Monastery over the last couple of days to figure out what the best plan for St. Mark's Parish is in the weeks to come as the novel coronavirus continues to spread and new directives on practicing physical social distancing are made. This past week has been full of disruption for many people. Each email and phone call bringing news that affects our lives and our communities. I do not come to you this morning with solutions to the problems we may face in the coming weeks, but I invite you to join me in looking for ways to see Christ as we move into these uncertain times. I recently read a poem by the Reverend Lynn Ungar, an author, poet, and priest in the San Francisco Bay Area. Earlier this week, she wrote a poem titled Pandemic. I would like to share it with you this morning. What if we thought of it as the Jews consider the Sabbath, the most sacred of times? Cease from travel, cease from buying and selling. Give up just for now on trying to make the world different than it is. Sing, pray, touch only those to whom we commit our life. Center down. And when your body has become still, reach out with your heart. Know that we are connected in ways that are terrifying and beautiful. You could hardly deny it now. Know that our lives are in another's hands. Surely that has come clear. Do not reach out with your hands. Reach out with your heart. Reach out with your words. Reach out all the tendrils of compassion that move invisibly where we cannot touch. Promise this world your love, for better or for worse, in sickness and in health, so long as we all shall live. As we move into the coming weeks, many of us isolated and finding ourselves working or learning from home, the most radically Christian thing we can do is devote ourselves to our communities. Devote ourselves by removing our physical presence, honoring the life of every human being by ensuring that we don't unknowingly carry contagions near them. And perhaps most importantly, making sure that through all of this, no one feels alone. We live in an age where at any given moment, anyone in the world is a phone call away. Our smartphones and laptops serve as visual portals into the lives of our loved ones and communities. I invite you to use these tools. As so many of us are worshiping from different physical locations this morning, I would like to offer a meditation that may help us focus deeply on our St. Mark's community for just a moment. If you are comfortable doing so, I invite you to close your eyes. It's Sunday morning. The worship service has just ended. You gather your belongings from your pew, and you head to the back of the church The organ is playing a dancing melody as you exit into the narthex. You place your bulletin in a basket and make your way to the parish hall, dodging children of all ages darting through the doors. You walk to the back of the sunlit room and pour yourself a hot beverage while offering a smile and thanks to the morning's hospitality team. You turn around and scan the room for a place to sit. You make your way to a table with an open seat and join a fellow parishioner. You look at their face and you notice how they look at you. Open your eyes. Who did you see? Who was serving coffee that morning? What children ran past you as you entered the parish hall? Who collected your bulletin? Hold their faces in your mind and their names in your heart. And when you end your worship this morning, call them. Send them a text message or an email. Pray for them during your day. Let them know you were thinking of them. And invite them to reach out to someone else as well. This is how we live as a community focused on Christ. This is how we meet people where they are, as Jesus met that woman at the well. This is how you and I, how we, the people who worship together and care about each other, are St. Mark's Parish. People are anxious and uncomfortable and scared. There are so many unknowns for so many people. Today, Paul shared an insight with us that we should hold on to. Hope does not disappoint us. I invite you to show compassion to those who are struggling, to have grace and patience and understanding as people figure out what their new temporary daily routine looks like. And I invite you most of all, to have hope. Your message to someone may be the only Jesus, the only light, the only life-giving water someone experiences that day. While we may not gather in the walls that physically represent our church home, our community is still here. It's still in the midst of us. I encourage you to think outside the box and engage with people in new and innovative ways. If you have an idea, share it. We are going to lean on and learn from each other during this time. I have hope that we as a community will lift each other up during this time. I invite you to have hope. We will get through this. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We will continue on page 7 in your bulletin with the Apostles' Creed. Let us proclaim our faith and say, I believe in God, the Father Almighty,
creator of heaven and earth.
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into the dead.
third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Let us pray for the church and for the world. Show us your mercy, O Lord,
and grant us your salvation.
Clothe your ministers with righteousness.
Let your people sing with joy.
Give peace, O Lord, in all the world.
For only in you can we live in safety.
Lord, keep this nation under your care.
And guide us in the way of justice and truth.
Let your way be known upon earth.
Your saving health among all nations.
Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten.
Lord,
create in us clean hearts, O God,
and sustain us with your Holy Spirit.
Almighty God, you know that we have no power in ourselves to keep ourselves. Keep us both outwardly in our bodies and inwardly in our souls, that we may be defended from all adversities which may happen to the body, and from all evil thoughts which may assault and hurt the soul. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
O God, you make us glad with the weekly remembrance of the glorious resurrection of your Son, our Lord. Give us this day such blessing through our worship of you, that the week to come may be spent in your favor. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I invite you to offer prayers, either silently or aloud or in the comments section.
For all people who are infected or facing quarantine, for the doctors, nurses, caregivers, first responders, leaders, and researchers working tirelessly to help. For the immunocompromised and those at higher risk of developing the disease. And for all of us who are hungry for connection and struggling to understand.
We pray also today for Milt Bracey, whose wife Linda passed away. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant Linda. Acknowledge we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and in the glorious company of the saints and page 8 in your bulletins, let us say together a prayer for healing. Hear my prayer, O Lord. In time of trouble I call you, for you will answer me. When pain and illness are my companions, let there be room in my heart for strength. When the days and nights are filled with darkness, let the light of courage find its place.
the suffering and dissolve the fear. Renew within me the calm spirit of trust and peace. Hear my prayer, O Lord. O God, you have made of one blood all the peoples of the earth, and sent your blessed Son to preach peace to those who are far off and to those who are near. Grant that people everywhere may seek after you and find you. Bring the nations into your fold. Pour out your Spirit upon all flesh, and hasten the coming of your kingdom. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of Christ be always with you.
And also with you.
Please greet one another with a non-physical respecting of our personal sign of God's peace.
Hey, everyone.
People in the comment section, feel free to type in peace or greetings to your neighbors.
God's peace, Kimberly.
Hey. Hey, Kimberly.
God's peace.
Oh, this is hard. Oh, this is good. Is there lots of peace in the comment section?
Yeah, there's lots of peace in the comment section.
Keeping a close monitor on that, call them.
We're all going to have to lean on each other in the coming weeks to make sure we all know what's happening and can take care of each other. Pastoral care, you can of course call Reverend Selling Monastery. Reverend Keith is still in recovery, but he is in very good spirits. Keep him in your prayers as he continues in that recovery. The offertory for today will not officially happen.
Could you please speak up as well? People are having trouble hearing.
They will be, you know, giving plans for how the kids should learn by Thursday, this coming Thursday, and that's all for that.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, campus will be more or less empty for the next couple of weeks, and please keep those students and teachers in your prayers as we learn very new teaching styles and learning styles. They will need all of your support and all of your prayers. I think that is all I have. Feel free to keep commenting your announcements below, but walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us.
Continuing on page 9 in your bulletin. Let us pray for our own needs and those of others. Let us pray. Thank you.
Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us evermore.
Amen.
Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for being here.